New Delhi has accused Islamabad of breaching its assurance of providing unimpeded, unhindered and free access to Kulbhushan Jadhav during the recent consular access. On 16th July 2020, Pakistan provided consular access to Jadhav for the second time since he was detained in March 2016. But the Ministry of External Affairs, MEA, said that when two Indian consular officials went to meet him, they found Pakistani officials with an intimidating demeanor near Jadhav and a camera was used to record the conversation. The Indian officials met Jadhav to discuss filing of a review petition in Islamabad High Court against his death sentence by the deadline of July 20 and required a privacy to talk about the matter. MEA spokesperson Anurag Srivastav also said the consular officers could not engage Jadhav on his legal rights and were prevented from obtaining his written consent for arranging his legal representation. He went on to say and add that in the light of these circumstances, the Indian consular officers came to the conclusion that the consular access being offered by Pakistan was neither meaningful nor credible. After lodging a protest, they left the venue. Meanwhile, spokesperson of Pakistan's Foreign Office, Aisha Farooqi, reiterated the country's offer to file an appeal in the Islamabad High Court against Jadhav's conviction and subsequent death sentence by a military court. Pakistan's Foreign Office's statement added that Pakistan remained committed to fully implementing the International Court of Justice's judgment on July 17, 2019 and said it is hoped that India will cooperate with Pakistan court in giving full effect to the said judgment. Pakistan's side also offered India third consular access to Kulbhushan Jadhav and said its official won't be present in the meeting. Kulbhushan Jadhav, a retired Indian Navy officer, was sentenced to death by a Pakistani military court on charges of espionage and terrorism in April 2017. Weeks later, India approached ICJ against Pakistan for denial of consular access to Jadhav and challenging the death sentence. In July last year, 2019, ICJ ruled that Pakistan must undertake an effective review and reconsideration of the conviction and sentence of Jadhav. The ICJ also ruled to grant consular access to India without further delay. The MEA spokesperson said, Pakistan is attempting to create a mirage of compliance with the ICJ judgment. He said that Pakistan has refused to hand over any relevant document including the FIR, evidence and the court order in the case to India. As per media briefing, Anurag Srivastav also alleged that Pakistan's claim that Jadhav, who is incarcerated in Pakistan's custody, has refused to initiate review petition is a continuation of the farce that has been in play for the last 4 years. He went on saying that Jadhav has been sentenced to execution through a fakical trial. He remains under custody of Pakistan's military. He has been clearly coerced to refuse to file a review in his case. He said India sought unimpeded access to Jadhav to discuss the remedies available to him under an ordinance, while saying that Pakistan is only seeking to create an illusion of remedy. And at last, he said, in a brazen attempt to scuttle even the inadequate remedy under the ordinance, Pakistan has obviously coerced Jadhav to forego his rights to seek an implementation of the judgment of the International Court of Justice. On May 20, Pakistan passed an ordinance to allow for the High Court to review the sentence awarded by the military courts. MEA said the ICJ has already held that Pakistan is an egregious violation of international law. Government will do its utmost to protect Jadhav and ensure his safe return to India. To that end, it would be considered all appropriate options. As per MEA, India has repeatedly asked to allow a lawyer from outside Pakistan to appear for Jadhav in any review and consideration proceedings, but Pakistan denied it. MEA said Pakistan has maintained that its laws allowed for effective review and reconsideration, but Anurag Srivastav has also said now, after almost a year, they have made a U-turn and issued an ordinance to ostensibly provide for some sort of review. We have already expressed our serious concerns at the content of the ordinance and how it violates ICJ judgment. The first consular access to Jadhav was provided in September 2019, but his mother and wife had been allowed to meet him in December 2017 only. In May 2020, Pakistan passed an ordinance ostensibly to comply with the order of the International Court of Justice. It envisages the consular office of the Indian High Commission filing a petition before a High Court to seek a review of Jadhav's death sentence. But for that, the contacts and conversations between the consular office and Jadhav holds great importance. New Delhi has also said it is clear that Pakistan's approach to this matter continues to be obstructive and insincere. It has not only violated its assurance to the ICJ to fully implement 2019 judgment, but also failed to act in accordance with its own ordinance. For the past year, India has requested Pakistan more than 12 times provide unimpeded, unhindered and unconditional consular access to Sri Kulbhushan Jadhav, who remains incarcerated in Pakistan custody since 2016. The ICJ had ruled in July 2019 that Pakistan had violated Jadhav's rights under the Vienna Convention on consular relations and upheld its earlier decision that his death sentence should be held in abeyance till his trial and conviction by a military court was reviewed. So the question is, why is Pakistan not complying fully with the ICJ rulings and is just indulging in show-off?